things. And one thing that we talked about was, first off, how God created everything. Good thing he created penguins for Tessie. And I'm also grateful that he created a bunch of other little animals, because as you know, I kind of have lots of little animals at my house, so I thank the good Lord that he made all those for us. And we also talked about how he gave us human beings, Adam and Eve, and to help take care of everything that he created, everything he did on that he brought to earth. We needed someone to take care of us, so he made us human beings. We talked about how we then were created in his image, and I had a mirror, and we passed that around, and I asked everybody if they looked like they were the image of Jesus. And of course I got no, and one of the funniest ones was, says, "No, silly, I'm a girl." Indeed. So, we talked about that, and then we of course talked about the only thing that keeps us from being perfect like Jesus is that nasty thing called sin. Okay, we all hope to go to heaven one day, and sin is what keeps us from doing that. We all know that heaven is perfect. Gotta be perfect to go up there and live with the good Lord. So we talked about how Jesus died on the cross for us to take sins away from us so we indeed can go to heaven with God. We did this little experiment, which was by far the best thing that we did the whole week. They really liked this, so I thought I would share it with everybody. And you might not be able to see it, but we'll be downstairs at the reception if you want to see how it works really close up, because it's really kind of cool. Okay, so first off, we have a saucer here, a little plate, okay? And that represents the world. And then we have a coin. Remember what this represented? Who is this? Us. This was us. The coin is us. Okay. Oops, I'm going to spill it before we get started. Then the water here in the cup represents sin. The candle, of course, represents Jesus because he is the light of the world. And then the glass is going to represent Jesus' death. Okay, so we're going to do this and we're going to see if we can get this to work. So first off, we're going to pour all this nasty sin into our world. Okay, and then of course we are in the world, right? So here we are, which you can't see, but now it's in the water, covered in the water. So the question was, can I get us out of that world without getting my fingers wet with sin?
Yes.
Not at first, can I? Everyone says no, the way that it is. Can I do it the way that it is, with it in the water? I cannot. So we need the help of God and Jesus' death to help us get all this sin away. Oh, I'm so sorry. Okay, so here we go. We're going to see if Jesus' death can help us get out of this sinful world. Go. The glass gets hot. That's why I let Jamie do it. So as it's doing that, Jesus dies on the cross and he sucks all of the sin, all the water up into the glass. You probably cannot see that because Jamie